All right. First and foremost, I want to give all praise, all glory, all honor unto the Most High God, whose name is Yahweh. I do so in the name of his only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. This is your brother, Officer Ariala Sakari Philly. I'm joined by War Dog, Yakuyam, and Soldier Gaius Sean, Soldier Priest Gaius Sean. All right. And through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, we're getting ready to do some commentary on the Javonte Tank Davis domestic violence situation and teach a lesson based off everything that transpired. All right. So if you living under the rock and you don't know who Javonte Tank Davis is, Javonte Tank Davis is a lightweight 135 pound superstar boxer. I believe he is 28-0, if I'm not mistaken. Let's see. So box right.
Yeah, either 28 or 27.
Yeah, he is the lightweight Mike Tyson, right? Let's see. Boom. Let's pull him up. Let me share my screen. Boom, right? So Javonte Tank Davis, he is 27-0. Right in the pros, he's 27-0 with zero losses, zero draws, and he has 25 wins by way of knockout. So he's a superstar, right? He co-headlined with Floyd Mayweather versus what was it, Conor McGregor, right? And this like propelled him to superstardom, right? So he's one of the most popular boxers, all right, in boxing right now, right? So there was recently a situation, there were recently allegations from Javonte Tank Davis's baby mother. I don't know the young lady's name, where the cops were called for a domestic violence dispute. Javonte was secretly arrested, right? And then he was released on bail, right? The bail amount, you have to pay 10% of the bail amount. The bail amount was $1,000. So he paid $100 to get out, right? Now, that should be telling based off of the severity of the bail. It was $1,000 and he paid $100 to get out, right? So if this was a situation that was of extreme gravity, right, his bail would have been a lot higher, right? And the reason why we're diving into this and to do a lesson on it is because this situation shows something that is a problem amongst Black and Hispanic people, right? We live in a world where we live by this motto in the Bible. That's not in the Bible, right? This motto is not in the Bible, right? It's this thought that only God can judge me, right? Only God can judge me. Right. Yet our people judge all the time. Right. And the issue is, there's nothing wrong with judging things. The scriptures actually teach you to judge. Right. But we're here to judge righteous judgment. Right. Gaius Sean, can you get that for me in the Gospels? Judge not according to the appearance.
This is the book of John, chapter 7, and verse 24. Judge not according to appearance, but judge righteous judgment.
So these are the words of who the world calls Jesus Christ, right? Whose true name in the Hebrew is Yahawashai, right? Hamashiach, meaning the Messiah or the Anointed, and Yahawashai. That's the name that his mother named him, right? They were Israelites, right? They lived in the land of Israel and they spoke Hebrew, right? And that was his name, right? Yahawashai. And again, everyone knows this as Jesus, right? The vast majority of Black Americans and Hispanic Americans, I have to believe it's 80% and 79%, right? 80% for Black Americans and 79% for Hispanics are, you know, alleged Christians, right? Followers of Christianity. Right. Well, the person whose name bears your religion, Christ, he said to judge not according to appearance, right? but to judge righteous judgment. Now, what is righteous judgment, right? Yeah, can you get Deuteronomy chapter 6 in the last verse?
Con. This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6, and verse 25. And that shall be our righteousness, if we observe to do all of these commandments before the Lord our God, as he hath commanded us.
So we see that the standard of righteousness are the laws of God, the Torah, something that is not taught in the Christian church, right? The Christian church does not teach its followers, right, its adherents to follow the laws of God, to follow the laws that you find in the first five books of the Bible, right? The average Christian, right, they have never read the scriptures from Genesis to Deuteronomy, right? The average Christian typically reads Psalms, maybe some Proverbs, the Gospels, and Paul's epistles. And the vast majority of their talking points, right, come from Paul's epistles and not actually from the words of Christ. But Guy Ashan, right, priest Guy Ashan read for us in the book of John, the 7th chapter, Christ, right, who 80% of black people claim to be followers of, right, said to judge not according to appearance, right, but judge righteous judgment, right? A colloquial idiom or phrase similar to that is do not judge a book by its cover, right? And that's the issue with our people, with so-called Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. We have fallen so far from our first estate, right? We have fallen so far from our standard of righteousness, right? Our standard of what is good and what is evil, right? And we live so far outside of the realms and the parameters, all right? Outside of the boxing ring of what the law of God puts us into, right? We fall so far outside of that we have forgotten what the standard of right, of what is righteous, or what is correct, what is upright, what is just, right? That's the problem. Our people have in their mind, right, only God can judge me, right? But here we have in the scriptures, Jesus Christ, who, again, 80% and 79% of Blacks and Hispanics claim to be adherents to here in America, he's telling you to judge righteous judgment. So we don't see this idea of not being able to judge, right? Being able to judge is something that we should be doing, right? We should be judging each other, right? Judging each other does not look like, how do I say this? Doesn't look like us turning our nose up at each other, right? Judging each other looks like us correcting each other, right? And loving each other, right? Let me get that in Leviticus, right? Leviticus chapter 19, all right, and verse 17. Guy Sean Bob Kushat.
Slaggy, I got a quick preset too.
Con, bring it out.
Con, this is the book of Psalm chapter 37 and verse 30. The mouth of the righteous speaketh wisdom, and his tongue talketh of judgment.
And his tongue talketh of what?
Of judgment.
His tongue talketh of judgment, right? Read that again from the top.
Con, this is the book of Psalm, chapter 37, verse 30. The mouth of the righteous speaketh wisdom.
The mouth of the righteous, right? So who is the righteous person? The righteous person is the one who is adherent to the laws of God, right? You cannot be righteous, right, if you're eating pork. You cannot be righteous if you're eating shrimp, crab, and lobster. You cannot be righteous if you are a talebearer. Right. And that's something that's prevalent in our culture. Right. We have organizations such as the Shade Room. Right. That on a daily basis posts, if not tens to 20s of posts. Right. Just reporting so-called news, but really spreading rumors. Right. And in this situation with Javonte Tank Davis, of course, them being a media outlet. Right. They reported on the situation. Right. And, you know, I'm not really too much really faulting the Shade Room for just reporting the situation, because it was news. Right. There's other outlets, other media outlets that have that share this information. Right. The issue comes in with the with the comments, right? The comment section, right? And let me just go ahead and put the fair use, all right? Fair use, right? We're commentating on public information, things that are publicly displayed, right? The issue comes with the comments for the most part, Black and Hispanic people who are the Israelites that you read about in the Bible, right? When the news came out of Javonte Tank Davis being arrested for an alleged domestic violence situation, right? People springboard into conclusions, right? People had all these opinions and ideas about what happened, right? And that goes against who 80 and 79% of Black and Hispanics claim to be their God, right? Claim to be their personal Lord and Savior, right? Your personal Lord and Savior, right? Personal, right? Because who the world calls Jesus Christ, Yahushua, is the Savior of the nation of Israel, which are so-called Blacks and Hispanics and Native Americans. He's a national Savior. He's not a personal Savior, right? Your so-called personal Lord and Savior said to judge not according to appearance, but to judge righteous judgment. We've established that what's righteous, what is the standard of righteousness, the standard of what is good and what is evil, right, is the laws of God, right? And according to the laws of God, in any situation in which we must judge between our neighbors, right, we must collect the information, right? We must collect the facts, do an investigation the same way the judicial system of the United States is supposed to be predicated upon, right? The judicial systems of the vast majority of first world and even third world countries are supposed to be predicated upon, right? Gathering evidence, right? Guyashan, get for me a Sirach where it says, understand first and rebuke. What's that, Sirach 11, if I'm not mistaken? Grab that for me, Baba Kushai. Sirach 11:7.
This is the book of Sirach. Chapter 11, verse 7. Blame not before thou hast examined the truth.
Blame not before thou hast examined the truth. Before you have examined the evidence, right? Read.
God. Understand first and then rebuke.
Understand first and then rebuke. That's what we must do, right? Now, rebuke is something that is important and something that our people, so-called Blacks and Hispanics and Native Americans, need to understand. And I'm not talking about the Christian, the good old Christian, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Hey, I'm not talking about that, right? I'm talking about the biblical rebuke, right? Let me get Proverbs, 27? Open rebuke. And then, Yach, let me get that Leviticus 19. Right, in verse 17, because this is of utmost importance.
God, this is the book of Proverbs, chapter 27, and verse 5. Open rebuke is better than secret love.
Open rebuke is better than secret love, right? If you love someone, you should rebuke them. What does it mean to rebuke? The word rebuke means to correct, right? We should be correcting one another, right? If we truly love someone, right? And that's a term that our people just throw around, right? Oh, willy-nilly, oh, yeah, I love you, bro. I love you, sis, right? Do you really, right? Do you really love your brother and your sister, right? Your fellow Black or Hispanic man, your fellow Black or Hispanic woman or Native American man or Native American woman, right, who are the Israelites, right? Do you truly love that individual, right? Loving your neighbor, right? Loving your fellow Israelites, right? And again, the Israelites are so-called Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans here in the Western Hemisphere, right? Looks like us keeping the commandments, right? Following God's commandments, us following righteousness, us being able to judge and rebuke based off of the righteousness, which is the standard, all right, which is, again, the law, right? So let's get that. Leviticus chapter 19.
God, this is the book of Leviticus chapter 19 and verse 17. Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
So here we have the Most High God, right? See, when you read the Bible, right, the Bible is about a family of people, right? The Israelites, right, who are the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, right? The Israelites, all right, walked into the land of Egypt, right? They lived there peacefully for a time, and then they were put into bondage or captivity by the Egyptians, right? While they were in bondage, they increased and they were multiplied, right? And then God sent Moses to tell Pharaoh to let my people go. They leave out of Egypt after a bunch of plagues hit Egypt, right? They crossed the Red Sea. They're wandering in the wilderness for 40 years before entering into the land of Canaan, right? Which would now be known as the land of Israel, right? So Moses is delivering the law, the instructions from their God, whose name is Yahweh, not Yahweh, not Jehovah, not Yahuwah. Yahweh is his name. Yahweh gives the commandments to Moses, and Moses gives the commandments to the people, right? And the commandments, the law, is supposed to be the Israelites' wisdom, understanding, and the sight of the nations, right? So they're being given these instructions. They're being bestowed wisdom, right? And that's something that our people desperately need, right? So it says in the law of God that we must not hate one another. Let's just stop right there. Imagine all the lives, right, that would be saved, right? All the lives that would not have been taken in vain, right? If Black and Hispanic people did not see each other as ops, right? The brother that lives on 65th does not see the brother on 63rd as an op. The brother that lives, all right, on Dorchester Road, all right, does not look at the brother on East 34th Street, all right, in Flatbush, right, as his op, right? The brother in the red flag doesn't see the brother in the blue flag, or the BD doesn't see the GD as his op. Imagine if we did not hate each other. Just imagine that, right? So our God, right, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Yahweh, commanded us, right, that we cannot hate each other. All right, read that again.
God, this is the book of Leviticus, chapter 19, and verse 17. Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart, your mind, right? Read.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
In any wise, right? If your brother is in error, you rebuke him. You correct him because rebuke is better than secret love, right? Open rebuke is better than secret love, right? You got people in your corner, a bunch of yes men, just aiding you and egging you on in your madness, right? In your foolishness, right? You don't need people like that. You need people who you can surround yourself with, who are wise, right? Who can check you when you need to get checked, right? Who can correct you when you're wrong, right? That's what we need. That's true love, right? Read.
Con, thou shalt anywise rebuke thy neighbor and not suffer sin upon him.
And not suffer sin upon him, right? What is sin, right? 1 John 3 and 4 says that sin is the transgression or the breaking of the law, right? So if you see your brother, right, and the verse is going to qualify and quantify who your brother is, right? If you see your brother doing something that is contrary to the instructions that our God, our Heavenly Father, the Most High God, Yahweh, gave us, right, they're in sin. You're supposed to love them by rebuking them, by correcting them, right, and not suffering that sin upon them. That's what God is commanding us, right? Read on.
Con. Thou, verse 18, thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people.
So we see right here, right, the children of thy people are being qualified as your neighbor, right? That's who your neighbor is, the children of thy people, right? God is saying, do not bear any grudge, right? Read that again.
Come. Leviticus chapter 19, verse 18, thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people.
So you cannot avenge, right? Oh, he did something to me, I'm gonna do it to him. That's avenging, right? Or you holding something bottled in, right? Because someone offended you, right? You shouldn't hold that grudge. You should go to your brother, let them know, yo, bro, like, this is what happened, pop, 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 right? I wasn't feeling that. This, and guess what? Y'all squash it, right? Imagine if we had that mindset as a people, right? Pops, your Pop Smokes, your King Bonds, all right? And every brother, right? Every brother and sister that is on the mountain list of Black and Hispanic men that have died, that have been murdered here in Philadelphia, right? Philadelphia has just reached over 500 murders for, what, the third year in a row, right? Philadelphia is supposed to be the city of brotherly love, but yet because our people hold grudges, because we avenge, right, each other, right? We don't love each other, and we live in sin, right? This is why all this death follows us, right? And something as simple, right, as just loving the next brother, right, loving your neighbor, right, that our people can't get that, right? And that's a curse, right, that God said would be on his people for them not keeping the commandments, right? That is a sign. Those curses are signs on who the Israelites are, right? That's what the scriptures say, right? So we must, of course, be able to judge righteous judgment. We must be able to love each other by keeping the commandments and keeping each other in check according to the commandments. That's the standard, right? These are the house rules, right? See, we can, niggas can agree on, you know, house rules for spades, all right, and Monopoly and silly games, right? But in the game called life, right, we can't agree on a set standard of rules. Here's the thing. The Most High God gave us a set standard of rules, right? And it's in your Bible. The same book that is collecting dust on your nana's nightstand, right? The same Bible that's probably somewhere in one of your closets, right? Collecting dust, right? It's your Bible from when you got christened, right? Or baptized when you were a baby, right? That book has the instructions, has a standard of how we, as so-called Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, the Israelites, must live our lives, right? And we're commanded to not hate each other, to love each other, right? To correct each other, right? That is important. So again, we see who the world called Jesus Christ, right? Jesus Christ being the Word of God, right? The Word made flesh, right? Who told us in Matthew 4:4 that we must live by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. The words that we just read in Leviticus 19, right? Proceeded out of the mouth of God. We must live by that, right? Read verse 16.
Come on, Leviticus chapter 19, verse 16. Thou shalt not go up and down as a talebearer.
As a what?
As a talebearer among thy people.
And that's something that people do, right? Again, your shade rooms, your Say Cheese. What's another one of these outlets?
TMZ.
TMZ. That's not owned by our people, but you know, we go with this stuff, right? We live in a culture that, you know, just get the story out right away, right? Don't collect any of the facts, right? And let's jump to conclusions. That's what our people do, right? Our people do that, and that is unrighteous. That is not how we're supposed to judge. Again, and this is the hypocrisy, right? Our people have in their minds, only God can judge me. Yet, we judge people in certain situations all the time. Do you know how many people judged Javante Tank Davis? Said, oh, Javante Tank Davis is this, that, and the third. Pop, 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 right? And didn't know nothing. As soon as I heard it, I was like, dang. First thing in my mind, I was like, well, this could, and this might sound kind of cold to somebody, right? And again, I'm not an advocate of domestic violence. That's something that our people need to get a grip on, right? Domestic violence, us as men, we must love our women and vice versa, right? We must love our wives as Christ loved the church, as the scriptures say, right? But when I heard about the situation, right, I didn't want to jump to conclusions. Why? Because I would be going against the Bible. The Bible tells me to understand first and then rebuke. Right? The Bible tells me, right, by the words of who the world calls Jesus Christ, Yahweh Shai, to not judge according to appearance, right, but judge righteous judgment. Just because I saw something, right, on the shade room, or I saw something, all right, on YouTube about this situation, I cannot judge based off of just that headline, right? that information. Right? I need to gather all the facts, right? I need to let things play out so that I can form an opinion on it, right? So before I can form a judgment on it, because again, there's nothing wrong with judging. The issue is our people judge according to appearance each and every day, right? And we judge unrighteously, right? We don't keep the law of God as our standard of righteousness, right? Therefore, it makes us unfit judges, right? Anyone got any precepts?
God, there was a little bit more of that, Sirach.
Yeah, bring that out.
God, this is Sirach 11 and verse 8. Answer not before thou hast heard the cause, neither interrupt men in the midst of their talk.
You see, before you've heard the cause, right, you should not be jumping to conclusions. And this is just sound wisdom, right? The book of Sirach starts off, right, in Sirach 101, all wisdom coming from the law, from the Lord, right? And the first wisdom that was given to our people were the laws, right? Was our standard of righteousness, was our standard of wisdom, right? What we were supposed to take hold of and do, right, as our wisdom and understanding in the sight of the other nations, right? But here we find ourselves, Blacks and Hispanics, we're not seen as wise and understanding people by the other nations, by the white man, by the Asian man, by the Arab man. Right. This is why when we scream Black Lives Matter, right, they laugh at us because to us, Black lives don't matter. Right. To us, right, we scream Black Lives Matter, but yet, you know, our women are number one in abortions, right? We never talk about or try to stop brothers from killing each other, right, in these different cities, right? So we're a joke to these people because we do not keep our wisdom. We're seen as a bunch of buffoons. By and large, by these people, right? They're cool with us because they like what we how we entertain them, right? They like to use us and to exploit us. That's what these other nations do. It's just a fact, right? But they don't see us as wise, right? You got a precept?
Yeah, cons. Look, and this all ties into that, right? Because our people also like to talk about, you know, how the laws of the land, you know, are largely unfavorable to us, right? And we want justice, right? But we judge each other the same way, like you're showing, mm-hmm. right? This is the book of Psalm chapter 82 and verse 2. How long will ye judge unjustly and accept the persons of the wicked, right? And this is what, like you said, like what we're doing. Like, we're not sitting back and making sure that we're judging ourselves correctly so that now we can correctly hold everybody else accountable for what they're doing to us. Right. Mm-hmm. And really look like we're innocent of what's happening to us. Right. But we're not looking innocent to what's happening to us at the hands of the other nations, because look at how we treat each other.
Mm-hmm. That's a fact. That's a fact. Right. Let's go to the book of Deuteronomy. Right. Deuteronomy chapter one. Right. This is important. Right. Go to Deuteronomy one. And. Yeah, go to Deuteronomy chapter 1 and start at verse 16, right? We'll get the point. Actually, verse 15.
This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 15. So I took the chief of your tribes, wise men and known, and made them heads over you. Captains over thousands, and captains over hundreds, and captains over fifties, and captains over tens, and officers among your tribe.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 16. Now charge your judges at that time, saying, hear the causes between your brethren, and uh-huh. judge righteously.
And judge what?
And judge righteously.
So again, this scripture right here demonstrates that this idea of only God can judge me is not biblical, and is not of God, right? God never said that. The Bible never said that. That was Tupac. Only God can judge me, right? No, we can judge each other, right? Because the word judge means to critically think, right? I can look at a situation, right? I should be, as an intelligent human being, right? I should be able to look at a situation, look at all the facts, and come to a judgment or to a conclusion based off of the facts that have been presented to me, right? I should be able to judge, right? And we are able to judge. We need to judge righteous judgments, and judging things according to appearance is not righteous judgment, right? Looking at Javante Tank Davis's past, right? His mannerisms, his attitude, right? His bravado, all of these things in this situation, factoring those things in, that's unrighteous, right? That's judging according to appearance. That's not you judging according to the facts of this situation. Each case must be judged righteously. We see these judges, these chief officers, right, of these tribes, right? Because again, this nation, so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, well, the Israelites, is divided into 12 tribes, right? And while we were in the wilderness, right, Moses set up officers, chiefs, who were tasked to be judges, to judge the matters between different Israelites, right? Read verse 16 again.
God, and I charged your judges at that time, saying, hear the causes between your brethren, and judge righteously between every man and his brother and the stranger that is with him.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 17, ye shall not respect persons in judgment.
Ye shall not respect persons in judgment, right? That does not mean that I do not have respect for you, right? That we shouldn't have respect for each other. What that's saying is I cannot allow my personal relationship with you, with anybody, to cloud my judgment in any matter, right? Let's say I'm judging between, all right, my homeboy and someone that I don't like, right? Well, guess what? I have to put that aside, right? The fact that this is my homeboy, and the fact that I don't like this other guy, right? Like, we have issues, we've had beef before, right? I have to judge this situation based off of the facts of that situation, right? If my brother's wrong, no matter whether or not he's my boy or not, right? Guess what? Well, I have to judge righteously, and I cannot respect his person and our relationship in said judgment, right? I can't say, you know what, because I don't like this guy, I'm a judge in your favor. Or because I like you, I'm a judge in your favor. Or because you're rich, all right, you can pay me bread, right? I'll judge in your favor. Or if this person's poor, right, and this person's rich, you know what, I feel bad for the poor person, I'm going to judge in their favor. We cannot do that. Right, we must judge righteous judgment. Right, read that again.
Salakia. I was gonna say the NLT gets it real nice and clear.
Fine, let's finish out the KJV and then we bring out the NLT.
Come, verse 17. You shall not respect persons in judgment, but you shall hear the small as well as the great. You shall not be afraid of the face of man, for the judgment is God's, and the cause that is too hard for you, bring it to me, and I will hear it.
So in the wilderness, right, Moses, because Moses was getting inundated, right? Imagine you got hundreds of thousands of people, right? Just imagine, right? You got black and Hispanic people. Because this is what our people got to understand, is that the Bible is about us, right? We cannot think about the Bible, all right, as being about some other people, right? When you just read the stories in the Bible, it's abundantly clear that these are niggas, right? These are black and Hispanic people.
God.
It's abundantly clear, right? So when we're reading these stories, right, and just imagine a bunch of black and Hispanic people walking around in the wilderness, right, just wandering, setting up tents. See, the vast majority of our people have never dwelt in a tent a day in their life, right? The vast majority. If you grew up in Brooklyn, right, or Philadelphia, for the most part, right, unless you was in the Boy Scouts, right, or you went to sleepaway camp, right, and in sleepaway camp, you went into a cabin, right? I'm talking about there's no cabin, right? There's no running water, right? You literally are wandering around, the wilderness is hot, right? It gets cold at night, right? You gotta walk for miles and miles and miles in a day sometimes, right? Imagine all the complaining and moaning and groaning, right? And all the quarrels between black and Hispanic people, right? By the hundreds of thousands, right? And Moses having to judge between these matters. Listen, that can't fall on one man. So this is why judges, right, captains and chiefs were elected amongst the tribes to hear these matters, small or great, right? And if it was too hard for them, they had to pass it off to Moses, because Moses was the guy. He was the guy that the Most High God was dealing with, right? Who was talking to, right? He was that prophet right, where the Lord wasn't talking to him, right, by, you know, dreams or similitudes, right? He spoke to him mouth to mouth, even apparently, as Numbers the 12th chapter tells us, right? So if the situation was too difficult, bring it to Moses. Moses would judge it. Bing, bang, boom, right? But again, we see that we're supposed to not judge according to the parents. We're supposed to judge righteous judgment. We have to hear out the facts, right, before we can jump to a conclusion, before we can render a judgment, right? And our people demonstrate on a daily basis how we are such poor judges, all right, of character, right? Such poor judges of situations, right? Even with the situation, right? When you go into everything that transpired with Javonte Tank Davis, right, and his baby mama, right? Again, the word judgment is to critically think. I'll be honest, right? Javonte Tank Davis, right? I love a brother, right? I even love a sister, right, in the situation, right? Because I'm commanded to love my people. Javonte Tank Davis was not a good judge of character in that woman to lay with her, right? And to create a child with her, right? Because a woman who will do what this woman did, and spoiler alert, right, if you haven't been paying attention, right, the woman admitted to lying that he was attacking her, right? Admitted to lying, right? So people jumped to conclusions, right, before that stuff came out. People ran, rendered judgments, right, according to appearance of a post that they saw on social media, right? And this woman came out and admitted that she lied about that situation, right? Javonte Tank Davis, all right, presented receipts of how this woman, right, ripped his shirt, right? They got into an argument. She ripped his shirt, spat on him, right? Put feces on his toothbrushes, right? This woman was on demon time, right? And she admitted to lying. She was in her emotions, and she lied, right? And that man got arrested, right? His name got dragged all through the mud, all through social media, right? And she admitted to lying, but here's the issue, and here's the learning, the lesson that needs to be learned. Our people need to stop jumping to conclusions. Our people need to take on the righteousness of God, which is these laws, statutes, commandments, so that they can be righteous judges, right? To be a righteous judge, that is important. Anyone got a precept?
So, like, yeah, I was going to read the NLT if you want.
Con, bring that out.
Con, this is the same book, Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 16 and 17 in the NLT. At that time, I instructed the judges, you must hear the cases of your fellow Israelites and the foreigners living among you. Be perfectly fair in your decisions and impartial in your judgments.
Be impartial in your judgments. Let's look at the word impartial, right? That is very important, right? Let's look up that word. Boom. Impartial. Treating all rivals or disputants equally, fair and just. Independent and impartial advice. Unbiased, unprejudiced, neutral, nonpartisan, non-discriminatory. Right? I cannot discriminate against this person because of his economical status, right? His socioeconomic status, right? I cannot rule in favor of this person based off of my relationship with them. That's what we're told not to do, right? And again, we have to hear out the cause or the matter, right, is about a specific situation. Anything outside of that, right, should not be used in the judging of that particular matter. Let's say again, right, because here's the thing, right? Javonte Tank Davis had a situation a few years ago, right, where his other baby mother, right, they were at a basketball game, and he, like, yoked her up and grabbed her out of her seat, right? I don't know the situation, right? Too many details about it, right? But people took that, knowing that, right, and they cast the judgment on Javonte Tank Davis in this situation based off of that, right? Now, I understand behavior is usually cyclical with people, right? And especially people who are guilty of domestic violence. Again, domestic violence is not anything, right, to shrug at, right? Not anything to, sweep under the rug, right? We're not advocates of that, right? We're advocates for our men, right? loving their wives, right, as Christ loved the church, right? We're advocates for wives loving their men, right? And us building stronger Black and Hispanic and Native American families, right? And domestic violence gets in the way of that, right? But again, this lesson is on righteous judgment, not judging things according to appearance, right? In order to judge righteously, you must look at the facts. You must look at the situation, right? And one of y'all got a precept?
Con, I was going to finish out in 17. Con, and that also goes into what I brought out earlier, us judging the same way how, you know, the slave master judges. And I'm well familiar with this. You know, you go to court, and what do? They bring up everything you've done in your past that they've kept record of. Mm-hmm. And then a lot of times they won't even care to check out the facts. You know, they'll talk about your past and make you feel so bad about what you did in your past so that when it's time to talk about a plea, you mm-hmm. don't even got to talk about the case. You want to take this plea because you already look like a guilty person.
Mm-hmm.
See what I'm saying? And that's what we do to our own people.
And also crazy is, again, we talk about how America, the American justice system is truly the American injustice system, right? And our people learned, right, unjust judgment here in America as slaves in America. So that's a great point.
Con. And it just went on to say, so be perfectly fair in your decisions and impartial in your judgments. Hear the cases of those who are poor as well as those who are rich. Don't be afraid of anyone's anger, for the decision you make is God's decision. Right? And why? Because like you said, it's facts. Right? The Most High said those that worship the Most High worship him what? In truth.
Spirit and truth. Spirit.
So that's why it's God's.
Huh? What you got, guys, Sean?
Kind of just going back on, because I was going through the comment section of the Shade Room too, and they was just roasting this brother Gervonta in the comments. They was just talking about, oh, when is it like, are we gonna wait until he murders somebody to actually take action and things like that? And this is wild. So this is Jeremiah 9:2.
Which post are you on? The initial post.
Hold on, let me see.
Or is it the post where it says the 911 audio?
Yeah, 911 audio, yeah.
Okay, let's look at the comment. So let's listen to the audio.
Unlock me in front of the audience. Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, repeat the address. I need to send you this to you. I need the address.
Please help me. You're going to kill me.
I'm trying to go home. I'm baby in the car. Unlock me in front of the audience. Okay, ma'am. Repeat the address. Ma'am.
So now look at this. Look at this goofball, right? The cliff, the gift, right? I have no respect for any man running around putting his hand on women, SMH. Right? Again, he hasn't heard anything. He wasn't witness to anything, right? But he's jumping to conclusions against Gervonta Tinker Davis that he put his hands on this woman, right? Ooh la la, Laura. Right? I wish y'all stopped making excuses for men hitting women. Well, she hit him first. This man is a trained boxer. It ain't no way she hit him that hard for him to hit, get back. Y'all got aunts, moms, sisters, homegirls. Let them do it. I don't give a F unless in danger. No reason for this, right? Again, right? Ooh la la underscore Laura, you are a fool, right? You and this guy, right, and the plethora of other people, right, who jumped to conclusions based off of appearance, right, and a false witness's testimony, right? Because before this was released, people jump to conclusions already. We can go to the previous one, right? But you are a fool, right? And everyone else who had a similar sentiment about this situation, y'all are all fools, right? Because y'all jumped to conclusions before y'all heard the facts of the matter, right? You guys are unrighteous judges, right? And even this comment is just insane, right? Well, she hit him first, because this is an excuse that people make, right? Ain't no way she hit him that hard. So let's say, right? Let's say hypothetical, right? This woman cracked him upside the head with a bottle. She didn't hit him that hard. Like, imagine getting clocked upside the head with a bottle, right? And then that didn't happen in this situation. But this logic shows that our people are illogical, right? This brother's name, his mugshot, right, is all over the interweb, right? His name is getting dragged through the mud, right? And again, as we've already spoiled it, this woman has admitted to lying in this situation. He did not hit her or her child, right? And he was rightfully angry and pissed off at people dragging his name through the mud, right? Slandering him, which again is something the law says that you should not do. Thou shalt not go up and down as a talebearer, right? You should not raise a false report, right? That woman, right? Javonte Tank Davis's baby mother, right? She is a false witness, right? In this situation, right? Let me get some precepts on false witnesses. While we're at it, let's look at another one.
Khan, what about the one where you received the judgment of a false witness?
Yeah, that's the one. That's if it's a situation of a corporal punishment, right? If I accuse you of adultery and you did not commit adultery, right? Then guess what? I got to get put to death because the judgment for adultery is death,
right?
Right. This isn't a situation where there should be a corporal punishment. But go ahead, guys, Sean.
Now, this is the book of Matthew, chapter 12, verse 36. But I say unto you that every idle word that man shall speak, they shall give an account thereof in the day of judgment.
Every idle word. Every single idle word. A word that don't mean nothing, that's just vain, right? You're going to have to give account for in the day of judgment, right? There's a day of judgment where every single spirit, every single soul is going to be judged, right? Whether they've done good or whether they have done evil, right? And you're going to have to give account for all the idle words that you have said, right? And guess what? The lawyer, right, who should be advocating, who should be your Johnny Cochran, right, is who the world calls Jesus Christ, Yahushua, right? And his blood does not cover you if you are living in sin, right? If you are breaking God's laws, if you are doing things like being a talebearer, right, if you are living a lifestyle, all right, of raising false reports, all right, if you're living a lifestyle, right, of having grudges and avenging, all right, your brother and sister, right, hating the next Black or Hispanic man or Native American man, woman, or child, right, if you're guilty of these things, if you're eating pork, right, all right, and you're breaking the Sabbath and you're just living a lifestyle of sin, all right, if you're just sleeping with every sister, right, and you a sister sleeping with every brother, right, all willy-nilly, guess what? In the day of judgment, right, you're going to be judged, all right, based off of your works, and you're going to be judged with death, right? It's just what the scriptures say, right? But let's look at a couple more of these comments.
I got a precept too, Con.
Con, bring that out.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 6, and verse 16. These six things doth Yahweh hate. Yeah, seven are an abomination unto him.
Mm-hmm.
A proud look, a lying tongue.
A lying tongue, right? What that woman did, right? God hates that, right? And guess what? God, the Christian church taught you that God hates the sin, loves the sinner. No, Psalms 5:5 says that God hates the worker of iniquity. He hates the worker of iniquity, the person who does the iniquity, the sinner. He hates them, right? So in this situation, the Most High God hates that woman for what she did, because she has a lying tongue, right? Read on.
And hands that shed innocent blood.
Uh-huh.
a heart that deviseth wicked imagination.
She devised a wicked imagination, right? When she went and called 911 and said that this brother did XYZ, when she know good and goddamn well that he did not, right? Read.
Khan and Salakia, that overthrew a lot of people in the comments, judgment. Mm-hmm. They caused them to, you know, have wicked imaginations.
Yep. Listen, it's sin is like a, like, talk about the web of lies, right? A lie is a sin. Lying to your people is a sin, right? Dealing falsely with your people is a sin, right? So as a, you got to tell one lie to cover up the next lie. Right now you have a web of lies, right? See how this one woman's sin caused a whole bunch of you Blacks and Hispanic men and women to sin?
Right.
And this is a sickness, right? This is the sickness that we need to cure, right? See, the thing is, we don't have, we as Black people, we don't have an economic issue, right? We don't have, you know, an issue of opportunity and things of that nature. That's not our issue, right? Money definitely is not our issue, right? Black and Hispanic people are the number one consumers in the world, right? The economy is on the backs of us spending money, right? So we don't have an economic issue. What we have an issue with is sin, with us breaking God's commandments. That's our issue, right? Read on.
Con, a heart that devises of wicked imaginations, feet that be swift and running to mischief.
Swift to running to mischief, right? The scriptures tell us in Leviticus, right? I think it's Leviticus. Correct me if I'm wrong, Kahan, right? Follow not a multitude to do evil, right? Here we got a whole bunch of people, right, who are judging unrighteously, which is evil, right? They're running together, right? They're swift to mischief, right? There's people who got bell notifications on the shade room, right? They want all the tea, all right? Spill the tea, sis. Oh, what's the tea, right? Our people are swift to running to mischief. To stuff that's not, ain't nothing productive the shade room ever promotes.
Right.
And give me, I need somebody to show me one productive and positive thing that the shade room produces. I'll wait. And don't tell me, oh, they're making money. Okay, cool. Rich is profit, not in the day of wrath. The love of money is the root of all evil, right? And you doing evil to get money, all right, is wicked, and you're going to be judged for that, right? Read on.
Verse 19. A false witness that speaketh lies, and he that soweth discord among brethren.
You see that? A false witness that speaketh lies. God hates that. It says a false witness that is a person. God hates that person. But again, Christianity teaches us that God loves everybody. No, God does not love everybody. God expresses his love for the Israelites. Right? And specifically the Israelites that are righteous in keeping his commandments, right? He hates the worker of iniquity, right? He still has a level of love for you, even if you are an Israelite, right? But again, you're going to see his wrath, right? Just like a parent, right? Your parent will whip you behind, right? But they still love you, right? Same thing with the Heavenly Father, with the Most High God, Yahweh, right? So again, this action, God hates it, right? Why do we as a people continue to do things, all right, and run to do things that God hates? Why do we run to go to Red Lobster, right, go to Crab Fest, right? Why do we run, all right, to go sleep with the next man's woman, right? Why do we run, all right, to the shade room to get all the tea, right, to get all the gossip and all the false reports, right? Why do we run to these things, right? Because we are running away from God, right? We're not walking with him, right? Can two walk together, let's be agreed? Right, we are walking contrary to the Most High God in every facet of our life. Right, when our people run to celebrate Christmas and New Year's and Father's Day and Mother's Day and Easter and all these other pagan holidays, birthdays of the sorts, right, we're running away from God, right, instead of going and keeping Passover, right, and New Moon and all these other holy days that the Most High God gave us, right, we run to the pagan stuff, we run to the stuff that we learned from our slave masters. Right, we don't run to what God says do, right? Because we run to these Christian churches that teach us that God's laws, done away with, don't worry about those. Jesus, hey, right, nailed him to the cross. Jesus ended the law. Can I get an amen? That's what we love to hear, right? Because we want to continue in wickedness, right? We like them smooth things. We don't like to be rebuked, right? Being rebuked don't feel good, right? But it's for your good. And that's something that's that medicine that our people need, right? I'm not talking about the penicillin, right? That pink medicine that actually tastes good when you were a kid. I'm talking about that Robitussin, all right? I'm talking about that good old cough medicine, that stuff that tastes, that NyQuil, right? That's what our people need. Our people need bladder. Our people need damn mullein leaf. We need all types of bitter herbs, right, to get us healthy, get us whole, right? And that medicine are the laws of God. That's what's going to heal us as a people, right? In this situation, right, with the Javonte Tank Davis and his baby mother, right, is a prime and gleaming example of how our people desperately need God, right? Desperately need these laws, these statutes and these commandments, this wisdom that we are so destitute of, right? Any of y'all got a precept?
Time. And this just goes back to the point of our people trying to be like the so-called white man, like you said, and all of this. And this is why Christ said this about many of our people, right? In the book of John, chapter 8 and verse 44, it says, ye are of your father, the devil, right? Here, Christ is talking to our people. He's mm-hmm. talking to the unbelieving Jews, which many of our people didn't believe on Yahushua the same way many of our people don't now, because they don't love their brother, right? They're not willing to lay their life down for their brother, right? It says, and the lust of your father you will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it, right? And we know this devil is really talking about the so-called white man. Right, we read in the book of Maccabees, it says, what? Not we didn't set by the honors of our fathers, but of the heathens the most. We love the Grecians.
Yep.
Right.
So that's it, man. Our people, as much as we talk all a good game, right? Our people love Massa, right? They do exactly what Massa say. And it's quite sickening, right? But let's get into some of this. I'm gonna pull up some videos, all right, from my beloved brother, Blue Bus Sports TV, the brother Aki TV, just, excuse me, on this situation, right? Let's see. Fair use.
Breaking news of Javonte.
Let's pause this one. Let's bring out.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Bus.
Yeah, let's go with this one first.
Sports TV. Back at y'all with it.
Salute to my brother Blue Blood Sports TV, right? This is my guy, man.
This fortunate situation that has taken place between undefeated three division world champion, former simultaneously WBA super featherweight super world champion, WBA regular lightweight world champion, WBA junior welterweight regular world champion, superstar boxer Javonte Tank Davis, who is 27 wins, no loss, no draw, 25 big wins by way of knockout. He is 28 years of age, 5'5" with a 67-inch arm reach. Javonte Tank Davis is scheduled to face off against undefeated WBA super featherweight Dominican star world champion in Hector Garcia, January 7th, next week, okay? And unfortunately, Javonte Tank Davis, ahead of his fight with Hector Garcia, has reportedly been arrested for a reported domestic violence case, okay? And so the fight between Javonte Tank Davis and Hector Garcia is now in jeopardy of not coming to fruition. Hector Garcia, 16 wins, no loss, no draw, 10 wins by way of knockout, 31 years of age, 5'9" with a 67-inch arm reach. They're scheduled to face off January 7th, which is next Saturday, okay? And Javonte Tank Davis, according to reports down in Florida, has been involved with a domestic violence case and has been arrested, okay, on domestic violence charges, allegedly, okay? And
now I love how Blue says allegedly, right? He's not jumping to conclusions, right? He's reporting the situation. the news as it's being put out, right? And he's not jumping to conclusions. He's saying allegedly, right? Reed?
He responds and he says, all I'm going to say was self-defense, okay? And here's one thing, and I'm not being insensitive to anybody in this situation and this equation, okay? But this is what I will say is that it's unfortunate because, again, we don't know what took place. And again,
you see that? Blue is admitting we don't know what took place, right? All I, me as a reporter, as a reporter in the sport of boxing, right? I'm just reporting this situation because it affects a boxer, right? In a very big fight that's getting ready to happen, right? So he's reporting the situation, right? And he says, we were not there. We don't know what happened, right? That's important, right? This man is exercising wisdom, right? And not jumping to conclusions based off of half information, right?
Let me say this. I'm not being insensitive to neither party.
And he has to clarify, right? The same way we clarify, because again, you have a lot of emotional people in our nation, right? So-called Blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans that are going to take what you're saying and spin it and run the other way, right? Instead of hearing what you're actually saying. That's what our people do all the time.
Okay. I don't know. Obviously, domestic violence includes this is going to include a female. No disrespect to anybody else. And this is going to include Javante Tank Davis. We don't know what took place. Okay. I'm not being pro Javante Tank Davis. I'm just being pro truth. Okay.
That is a beautiful thing that the brother just said. I'm not being pro Javante Tank Davis, right? Blue Blood Sports, who I tune into on a daily basis. This is when I say this is my guy. This is my guy, right? I'm a channel supporter of his, right? So I get all of my boxing news for the most part from Blue Blood Sports TV, right? Dante's Boxing Nation, and Aki TV, right? And I like these three guys because they're Aki more. I would say Aki out of all of them, right? He will definitely, right, let his feelings about particular boxers show, right? Like it's very clear that he doesn't like Mexican fighters, right? He's pro black fighters, right? But Dante and Blue, for the most part, they just report things as it is, right? And Aki does too, to an extent, right? But Blue, I would say out of all of them, right? He's about, well, what are the facts, right? What is the truth, right? His whole big thing is against people who are casual boxing fans, right? Just running with narratives and with the trends and things of that nature, right? He's a fan of the sport of boxing, right? And I've learned a lot about the sport of boxing from his commentary, from his analysis of fights, and me just diving into and watching more boxing matches, right? And not just the people who you know, right? Everyone knows Ryan Davis because of social media. Everyone knows Javante Tank Davis because of social media, because he's a superstar. Everyone knows Floyd Mayweather and Canelo Alvarez, right? Most people don't know who Jerron Boots Ennis is. Most people do not know who Rashidi Ellis is. Most people do not know who, all right, Akeeshawn Davis is, right? And et cetera of other fighters, right? So he's not a casual boxing fan, right? So he's pro truth and pro, just pro the sport of boxing, right? And he's a reporter in the sport of boxing, right? And in this situation, he beautifully demonstrates, right, a gift, right, a gift that the Most High God that gave, right, wisdom, right, to not jump to conclusions on a situation without hearing the facts, right. That's smart. And the thing is, a lot of our people do not do it. Let's run that back a little bit.
No, anybody who's a, this is going to include a female. No disrespect to anybody else. And this is going to include Javante Tank Davis. We don't know what took place. Okay. I'm not being pro Javante Tank Davis. I'm just being pro truth.
Okay? Being pro truth. Let's figure out the truth, right? Because there's a saying in the world, men lie, women lie, and numbers don't, right? There's another saying in the world, it's your side, my side, and the truth in between, right? in order for us to get the truth in between, right, we have to judge the matter righteously, right? Hear both sides, hear all of the facts, right? And examine those facts to come up with a conclusion and to determine what is the truth, right?
Okay. We weren't there. We don't know what took place. And everybody, because of Javonte Tank Davis's past, okay, and because Javonte Tank Davis has a case already running and open in a unfortunate hit and run situation in his hometown of Baltimore, and we saw the videotape of Javonte Tank Davis with the altercation with his children's mom, everybody's going to assume that Javonte Tank Davis is guilty.
You see that? Everyone is going to assume that Javonte Tank Davis is guilty. Guys, Sean, get us a Cyrac 11 and 7 again. Everyone's going to assume, right? We're going to jump to conclusions, right? What's that phrase about assume? All right, when you assume, you make an ass out of you and me, right? You look like an a-hole, right? Because you jump to conclusions, right? 95% of these people hearing these comments are fools, right? You look like an a-hole, right? Because you jump to conclusions before hearing the matter, before understanding the facts. Bring that out.
God, this is the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 11 and verse 7. Blame not before thou hast examined the truth.
So you cannot blame Javonte Tank Davis before you have examined the truth, right? Read.
God, understand first and then rebuke.
Understand the facts first and then correct or rebuke, right? Read.
God. Verse 8, answer not before thou hast heard the cause.
And answer not before you have heard the cause. Y'all just heard a headline, right? You didn't hear the cause. You didn't hear the cause between your brother and your sister, right? You didn't examine the facts and judge this situation righteously as God commands us to in his instructions, in his law, the Torah. Right? Finish that out. You see that precept?
God.
Bring it out.
God, this is the book of Proverbs, chapter 18 and verse 13. He that answereth a matter before he heareth it, it is folly and shame unto him.
Read that again.
God, this is the book of Proverbs, chapter 18 and verse 13. He that answereth a matter before he heareth it, it is folly and shame unto him.
It's folly and shame unto 95% of you bozos, all right, on social media. Right. I remember when the situation happened, right? And again, I'm hearing it and my mind is similar to Blues. Like, damn, that's this isn't good, right? This don't sound good, right? This doesn't look good. But again, I'm not gonna jump to conclusions right before I've heard all the facts, right? Guess what? He got arrested. Okay, that means that the cops are involved, that means they're doing an investigation, right? So I have to wait to hear what the cops have delivered, right, before I can jump to conclusions whether he's guilty or not, right? Even in America, right, we have this thing called innocent until proven guilty. But no, our people operate, and most people operate out of guilty until proven innocent. And guess what? There's probably people still who think that he's guilty. I guarantee you, right? But again, the Bible says it is folly and shame unto you if you speak on a matter before you have heard it. It's folly unto a lot of you people, man. And you listen, you know Eve, right? Is having a feel. Look at Eve just giving paragraphs, right? Paragraphs, right? Look at these people. It's insane, right? But our people need to learn, right? And the only way that we're going to be able to learn the right things is by coming back to this Bible, man, right? And not just living, not just reading, all right, the last one third of the Bible, right? And twisting everything in it, right? No, we have to start from the beginning, right? We got to start from the introduction, which is the laws of God. Then we got to read throughout the history and the prophets, then the gospels, right? Then the Acts of the Apostles and the apostolic epistles. That's how we must read the Bible, right? We got to start off with God's laws internalize that, and then go from there. And that's and apply those that wisdom that we get from the law to our lives in order to better our lives, right? To, in order to better our communities, in order to better our families, right? Javonte Tank Davis, he needs the laws of God, right? That sister, right? His baby's mother, she needs the laws of God, and they need to be raising that daughter of theirs, right? Keeping the laws of God, all right? This also, right, shows that a lot of times our men, right, are poor judges of character when it comes to dealing with these women, right? Because, listen, I can't lie, right? I'm not sure if you can find a picture of the sister. The sister is very beautiful, right? She's a beautiful sister, right? I can see what he saw in her, all right, to fall for her, right? But again, there's a saying in the world, do not trust a big butt and a smile, right? The scriptures warn us about following after that strange woman, right? The Bible gives us a juxtaposition of a righteous woman versus a wicked woman, right? And this woman is wicked, right? And Javonte Tank Davis, he's wicked too, right? He doesn't keep the laws of God, right? He needs repentance, right? But this whole situation is so much that we can learn from this situation as a people, right? When y'all got a precept?
Con, if you wanted to one on the woman topic, just a quick one in Proverbs chapter 14, verse 1. Mm-hmm. It says, every wise woman buildeth her house, but the foolish plucketh it down with her hands. And that's you know, pretty much what's going on right there. You know, clearly the sister, you know, she's risen a child for the brother, right? She's going to carry on his, you know, she's the fruit of his loins, right? Which makes that a part of his house, right? And what you're doing is you're bringing shame on your child. You have a child together, right? Mm-hmm. So this could be, you know, put in with the house part, right? Y'all build a house together. Y'all had a child, right? And now, you know, you're bringing shame to that very child because you want to just be contentious or whatever it is that caused you to lie on the man that helped, you know, put that child in you so that mm-hmm. you can nurture it and, you know, you can build that child up, right? You're not only bringing shame, and now you brought shame to yourself, right? Because you lied, right? You openly lied and, you know, bring shame to him. And now it's just shame on the whole situation.
Right? Yeah. And it's shame on all the fools that spoke on it before even understanding everything, right?
Right.
This situation is crazy, right? Let's go back to Blue, right?
When we don't know what took place, and Javonte Tank Davis is responding saying that it was self-defense, okay? And how do we know what took place? Now, I will say this. Javonte Tank Davis is in training camp. Javonte Tank Davis should be 1,000% focused on, you know, his fight with Hector Garcia, you know, and it's next Saturday. Okay, this is the worst timing. Again, let me say this. I'm not being insensitive to the other party, right? I don't know the other party. I'm not familiar, and I'm not saying the other party is not legit, okay? What I am saying is that we don't know what took place. So we need to wait until all the details surface. Okay. We need to wait.
That is wisdom. And here's the thing. This so many times, right? Our people, right? Our brothers and sisters, right? They be exhibiting, right? That they're the children of God, right? Just in their actions, right? In certain situations, right? Right, the scriptures say that the spirit of God testify with our spirit that we are the children of God, right? Roughly paraphrasing, right? Paul talks about the Gentiles, right? Do by nature the things that are in the law without the law, right? Roughly paraphrasing, right? In the book of Romans, right? In this situation, Blue, it would be a Gentile, right? He would be a Greek, right? He's been Hellenized or he, in context of the scriptures, right, he has taken on a culture that has been created here in captivity, right here in America, right? As all of us, right? All Black culture, Hispanic culture, right? Has been created through trauma, through slavery, right? We're not keeping our true customs, our true culture, our true heritage, and our true history, right? But again, he is through wisdom, right? In his speech, echoing the scriptures. Why? Because we are inherently the children of God, right? This is wisdom right here.
Until, you know, we understand what actually took place. And if there's video footage that can tell us the truth, because there's always three sides to a story. It's going to be Javonte Tank Davis' side. It's going to be the significant other side. And it's going to be the truth in between, right? Not saying that Javonte Tank Davis is not telling the 1,000% truth, and not saying that the significant other party is not telling the 1,000% truth. But at the end of the day, we don't know what took place. We weren't there. Okay, so I'm not being insensitive. I'm just saying this is unfortunate. This is a massive card. This is Javonte Tank Davis's first opportunity to be on his own since signing with legendary, retired, iconic Hall of Fame superstar boxer Floyd Mayweather Jr. and Mayweather Promotions. Now he's promoting GTD Promotions, Javonte Tank Davis Promotions, okay? He's headlining a massive card that's going to feature Jerome Boots Ennis. It's going to feature Rashidi Speedy Ellis. It's going to feature Demetrius Boo Boo Andre. It's going to feature Lamont and Anthony Peterson. It's in D.C., okay? This is a massive fight card, right? And it's in jeopardy of now not coming to fruition, not to mention the situation. I don't know how this is going to play out with his other situation that he already has open, but it's not going to bode well for that situation because, again, Javonte Tank Davis is a young African-American that is rich, wealthy, and is an athlete, and people are already going to condemn Javonte Tank Davis because of that.
You see that? Blue is speaking so much wisdom in this situation, right? He's identifying this is a Black man, young, right, in America. People are already going to judge him unrighteously, right? But he is saying, I'm not going to judge unrighteously without saying it, right? I'm not going to jump to conclusions, right? I'm not going to cast a judgment on the situation without hearing all of the facts. And that right there is wisdom, right? Let's end on this one. Let's bring this one out real quick. Let's just play Aki's because it's a little, it's probably a little shorter.
Tank Davis, baby mom. She came out pretty much admitting that she lied on Javonte when she had him locked up with the.
Now this is I'm assuming this is one of his posts on Instagram, Javonte Tank Davis, right? And I believe he has taken it down since after his name was cleared, right? Javonte does that a lot. He'll post something and then he'll delete it, right? But he was trying to clear his name, right? He goes into how he. You know, he's never put his hands on the woman, never put his hand on his child. Like he's upset about the situation, about how this is all set up, right?
Domestic violence, where she posted on Instagram, quote, "These past days have been hurtful and extremely exhausting for all parties involved. I pride myself on being extremely private. This situation was the last thing I wanted to be made public. The state of our relationship has been in a fragile space, and Javonte and I were both at fault for the argument. While the emotions were running high, I made an unnecessary call to the law enforcement in an intense moment while I was frantic. Javonte did not harm me or our daughter. Today, we have sought the help necessary to move forward with our lives. I'm confident that we will succeed with our co-parenting dynamic. With the consoling provided to us." End of the quote. "I hate to tell you I told you so, but I did tell you so on my last Javonte video of him providing proof of his baby mom spitting on him, ripping his shirt off, and putting doo-doo on his toothbrush. Well, after all, it turned out it's Javonte, the one that's in an abusive relationship. I mean, for Javonte's baby mom to try to assassinate Tank's character by calling 911, claiming Tank hit her and he almost was going to kill her, only to find out she lied, where she admitted, quote, 'Javonte did not harm me or our daughter.' End of the quote. That type of girl checks all type of red flags. I mean, if a person did not harm you, why would you call 911 claim?
And I'll stop it at that, right? Again, he makes a great point, right? This type of woman, and a lot of our women are like that, right? And here's the thing, right? So many times our people, it's this thing amongst black women, right? Oh, believe black women, right? And I'm not saying this, don't believe black women, right? I'm not saying that, right? But I can't just believe a black woman just because she's a black woman. I can't, because God's law tells me that I must hear out a matter, right? I cannot judge according to appearance, and I cannot respect persons in judgment, right? But yet our people respect persons in judgments all the time. Yet our people, right, judge unrighteously, right? Each and every day. And this situation is a prime example of that, right? So we as a people got to do better, right? And the only way that we're going to do better is by coming back to these laws, these statutes, commandments, right? You so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, y'all are the Israelites. The reason why you're in bondage, right? And yeah, even to this day, you are in bondage. You pay taxes, you're in bondage, right? Your uncle, right? He in jail, right? Your brother, he in jail. Or your cousin, Chico, he in jail. Guess what? He's a part of the prison industrial complex. He's a slave, right? We're still in bondage to this day. Right. And the reason why we're in bondage is because we, God's chosen people, the children of Israel, right, did not keep his commandments, right, which entail us judging righteous judgment, which entails us not judging according to appearance, which entails us not respecting persons in judgment, right, entails us not worshiping other gods, right, primarily, right, us keeping the Sabbath day and other holy days, or us keeping a particular dietary regimen, right? All of this stuff is outlined in God's laws, right? In his instructions for us, all right? And we just won't follow instructions, right? And this is why we have got put on slave ships and sent all over the world to serve other people, because we did not want to serve our God, right? We did not want to be righteous. We did not want to uphold his laws, his statutes, and commandments. This is important, man. Right, and this situation demonstrates, right, how our people desperately need these laws, such as commandments. Either y'all got any precepts or points?
Nah.
I only got one little precept just to wrap this thing up. This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 9, verse 2. Oh, that I had in the wilderness a lodging place of wayfaring men, that I might leave my people go from them, for they be adulterers, an assembly of treacherous men. This is what's basically going on. This is what we see going on with our people. As soon as some little thing happened, they go to villainize you and demonize you instead of finding out what actually happened.
You see that? Listen, the Bible got our people down to a T. Why? Because we're the people of the book, right? We are the people of the book, right? And we have to come back to keeping God's laws, his statutes, and commandments if we want to be elevated, right? Everyone's talking about getting a bag, right? Leveling up. Oh, new year, new me, right? You're this so-called new year, and it's not the new year because we're in the dead of winter, all right? This Gregorian calendar is hogwash, okay? So-called new year, new you, right? Why don't you renew your mind, right? Why don't you wash your brain of all the filthiness that's inside of it, that you have internalized through trauma and bondage, right? Why don't you liberate yourself through the truth, right? Who the world calls Jesus Christ, Yahweh Shah, says, ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. The truth is God's law, statutes, and commandments. Who the world calls Jesus Christ, he's the truth, the way, and the light, right? Following him, right, as your example, right, of someone who was faithful even unto death and keeping God's charge and commandments, right, that's how we should model our lives, right? That should be your New Year's resolution. Your New Year's resolution should be you coming back to these laws, statutes, and commandments, right? You making yourself, all right, and preparing yourself to be a righteous judge, right? You loving your fellow Black and Hispanic, right, and Native American, right, your fellow Israelite. That's what you should renew, right? You should put away grudges, right? You should stop avenging, all right, your people in certain situations, right? That's what you should stop doing, right? That's the resolution that you need to make, right? And you need to come back to these laws, these statutes, and these commandments, all right? But with that, we give all praise, all glory, all honor unto the Most High God, whose name is Yahweh. We do so in the name of his only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai, who the world calls Jesus Christ, right? If you're new to the channel, right, please like, share, subscribe, super chat or super thanks if it's on your heart, all right? I hope brothers and sisters were edified. Until next time, we'll say shalom. Shalom.